गुड आफ्टरनून चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप दैट यू आर ऑल गुड. माई सेल्फ दीपा, आई एम टीचिंग सोशल साइंस. द चिल्ड्रन, यू ऑल नो दैट फ्रॉम टुडे ऑनवर्ड्स वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट व्हाट्सएप क्लासेस. टुडे आई विल सेंड रिकॉर्डेड वीडियो एंड रीडर बुक कॉपी. स्टूडेंट्स, यू आर नॉट टेक द बुक्स. फर्स्ट यू गो टू स्कूल एंड टेक द बुक्स विद इन दिस वीक और दिस मंथ. ऑलरेडी वी सेंड वीडियोज एंड वर्कशीट ऑफ लेसन नंबर 1, ग्लोब्स एंड मैप्स. करेक्ट स्टूडेंट्स, वॉट डू यू हैव टूडे? You have to do listen the class first, then you read the lesson globes and maps. Shall we move, children? Lesson number 1, globes and maps. In this lesson, what will you learn? You learn about introduction. Second one, the globe. Third one, maps. Fourth one, language of a map. Okay, students. First one, introduction. We live on the planet Earth. Correct, students? Where we live? We live on the planet Earth. We know that the Earth is round. But for a long time, it was believed that the earth was flat. This view was changed around 500 years ago by the Portuguese explorer Ferdinand Magellan, who sailed westwards around the world with 5 ships. This view was changed? Portuguese explorer Ferdinand Magellan. Okay, he sailed 5 ships. After 3 years of traveling, one of his ship reached the same place from where he had started. This long journey proved that the earth is round. Okay, students. The earth is so big that we cannot see or study the whole earth of it at the same time. Therefore, to study the earth, we use a model of the earth called the globe. Okay, students. Second point, the globe. This picture shows globe. Okay, students, a globe is a small model of the earth. It is round in shape like a ball. See, this globe looks like a ball. Correct, students? This shape is called a sphere. It helps us to study the earth and gives us an idea about the shape and location of different continents, countries, oceans and seas. The rod on which the globe spins represent the earth axis. The axis is the imaginary line passing through the earth surface, earth center on which it spins. See this picture, students. In this, one rod is there, correct? This is called earth axis. This is a imaginary line passing through the center of the globe or earth. However, a globe we cannot much use due to the following reasons. Which reasons? First one, we cannot see all the places on a globe at the same time. A globe has to be turned to see what lies on the other side. Second reason, all the places on the earth cannot be shown on a globe. Third reason, globes are difficult to carry from place to place. Okay, students, now what is a globe? A globe is a small model of the earth. Why we cannot much use globe? Give reason. What will you write? First reason, we cannot see all the places on a globe at the same time. A globe has to be turned to see what lies on the other side. All the places on the earth cannot be shown on a globe. Third one, globes are difficult to carry from place to place. Okay, students, now let's study about maps. A map is a, what is a map? A map is a drawing of the whole or part of the earth surface on a flat surface such as paper. A map gives us information about places on the surface of the earth. Okay, students, what is a map? A map is a drawing of whole or part of the earth surface on a flat surface such as paper. What it will give? Map gives us information about places on the surface of the earth. There are various types of maps, are there? Okay, students, first one, physical map. This map shows, see this picture, students, this map show physical map. It shows physical features such as mountains, seas, rivers, lakes, forests and farms. Okay, students, this is called physical map. In this physical map, what it show? Mountain, where it is mountains, where it is seas, or where it is river. Okay, students, now second one, political map. It show countries or capital cities and other important places. See children, this map show political map. In the political map show countries, where it is country, where is India or where is China, okay, where is Pakistan, like that. And capital cities, okay, where it is capital cities of our country and other important places. Third one, thematic map. It shows themes or topics such as rainfall, crops, industries, etc. Okay, see children, see this map. This is called thematic map. In this map, what it show? Where it is rainfall will comes, or where it is industries, which crops are grow in which place. Okay, this map will show. A book of various types of maps is called an atlas. What is an atlas? A book of various types of maps is called an atlas. In this lesson, here students, three maps are there. Which one? Physical map, political map, thematic map. What I will do? I will do a book of book, one book. Okay, that book is called an atlas. Okay, students, now fourth point, what you study? Language of a map. The language of a map includes direction, scale, legend or key, color and symbol. It is the most important part of a map. Which one is most important of part of a map? Language of a map is very important part of a map. Now we will study about these are which one direction, scale, legend or key, color and symbol. Okay, students. First one, what? Language of a map, direction. Why you use direction in a map? They help us to locate a place easily. Maps are drawn with a symbol like this. This is the north direction, is at the top. See children, this picture you see in this, where it is north direction? Here, correct? Is it at the top? Opposite to the north is south. See children, north opposite which direction is there? South. Right to the north is east. See north direction here. Right side what is there? East direction. And left which direction is there? West direction. Correct students? Between the north and east, the northeast lies. Okay students, next, between the east and south, southeast direction will lie. Okay students, now see, now south and west direction, southwest direction will lie. Between the west and north direction, northwest direction will lie. Okay students, now these are the four main directions are there. Which one? North, south, east and west are called four main direction. What is this? These are, okay, northeast or southeast, which one? These are called sub direction. Okay, sub direction, which one? Northeast, southeast, southwest and north west. These directions are called sub directions. North, south, east and west are called main direction. Northeast, southeast, southwest, northwest. These directions are called sub direction. Okay students, now second point, what is the language of a map? Scale. Correct students, why you use scale in a map? Because to show the size and distance between place on the map is shown by scale. For example, Delhi and Jaipur is distance is 100 km. Actual distance is 100 km. In the map, we cannot draw the 100 km. Correct students? So, therefore, we show in a map 1 centimeter is equal to 100 kilometer. Means, okay, in 1 centimeter will show means, that is indicate 100 kilometer. Okay students, now next language of a map, what? Legend or key. Why you use legend or key? The legend or key of a map explains what the colors and symbols used in the map mean. These colors and symbols help us to read the map. See, here some all the maps have some colors, okay, which indicate some contents. See, blue color in this map is there means what it indicate? It indicate water bodies such as oceans, seas, rivers, lakes, etc. Okay students, second one, brown. Brown color shows hills, mountains and plateaus. Next, yellow color. It shows hot desert. Next, white color. It shows cold desert and snow-covered areas. Next, green color. It shows plains and lowlands. Okay, students. In the map, blue color is there. It shows water bodies. Brown color is there. It shows hills and mountains or plateaus. Yellow color shows hot desert. White color shows cold desert or snow-covered areas. Green color shows plains and lowlands. Okay, students? Now, symbols. You are moving on the road. You can see some symbols. Correct, students? Why they are showing? Why they are using? Symbols are using because to mark on maps to show railways or hospitals, roads and many things. See, I will example. See, post office or temple. See, this picture is there means you can understand. Oh, here some temples are there. Okay, this one you see, church or hospital, this symbol we will see on the that roadside also, correct? We are thinking, what will think? Oh, here in this place, hospital is there, okay? Next, grids. Maps have lines drawn over them to form squares called grids. See this, look at this map, students. Here some grids are there. These grids are make a squares. These are called grids. Okay, students. Next, advantages of a map. First advantages what? They are small and handy. Second one, they can be folded and carried easily to different places. They show small areas in great detail. Okay, students, advantages of a map, what we'll write? First one, they are small and handy. They can be folded and carried easily to different places. They show small areas in great detail. Okay, students, I hope that you are all understand the lesson. Thank you.